कुलदीप श्रीनगर है इधर ही
चल मनोज तू बड़े
मैनिफेस्टो
have been forced to volunteer, as is typical of the Indian Army. But I do hope that by the end of this session of approximately a week, some of you will go back from here with some kind of interest in the subject that we are going to talk about, if nothing else. I know one or two of you are involved in projects which deal with the subject. So you, those chaps are going to pay a little more attention, I'm sure. The main thing is that it's an exciting situation actually to be where you are, because this is a subject, the field of robotics. Well, when I was a youngster, when I was doing my own degree, robotics was still in the realm of science fiction. Isaac Asimov and people, we read about robots in science fiction. We knew it's coming up, it's going to happen. We couldn't at that point of time comprehend the state to which robotics is going to develop. And today we stopped anticipating what technology can produce. As you know, robots have found great use in industrial automation. That's where most of the applications are. But Japan has been in the forefront getting humanoid robots doing a whole lot of things, including replacing pretty waitresses in restaurants. Whether that's a good thing or a bad thing, we'll see later. The armies around the world have started taking an interest in robotics. if you know, UAVs have been in existence for quite some time now. The Indian Army itself has had its UAV for a fair amount of time. And a UAV is nothing more than a robot that uses flying as a form of locomotion. So we have been exploiting robots to some extent. Space technology, of course, perforce involves a lot of what we know today to be robotics in terms of telecommand and control. But the Indian Army has got suddenly very interested in robotics applications for the Army. The MCT is doing a certain amount of work in trying to conceptualize and visualize applications for robots for the Indian Army. So you're, when I said you're at an exciting stage, you are now looking at technology which is still in the thinking process as far as the planners in Army headquarters is concerned. There's nothing on ground. Unlike other systems that you see, there are some like carrier Ethernet and so on, which you are, which is not yet deployed on ground but is available in our labs. Tetra is another example of a technology which is available in our labs, not yet available on ground. But the thinking process for that, the acquisition process for those are well advanced. Not so for robotics. By the time robotics applications will find implementation in the Army, we are probably looking at something like 5 to 10 years from now. That's when all of you are going to be in the planning and perhaps in the implementation stage. So you are going to be part of this, those of you who show an aptitude, show an interest in this field, you are probably going to be the pioneers for the induction of robotics into the Indian Army. To that extent, the field is going to be exciting. And like all new fields, the development is driven by passion. Rarely does a standardized research and development setup produce anything of import. Our own DRDO organization is one such. It's a structured organization for research and development, yet very little comes out of these laboratories. It is those laboratories which are driven by passion that actually produce anything of utility. Robotics is one such. And the team that's here to guide you through the basics of robotics is one such team that is driven by passion. Rajiv Sinha has been in this field ever since his BTech at IIT Kanpur. They now trying to put together, not just put together robots for commercial applications, but to be able to spread this awareness and knowledge that they have obtained across. This is the second in the series of such workshops that we've had. We had one on real-time operating systems and embedded systems a little earlier. This is a more formalized one with this BRICS organization, which is Build Robotics, Create Science. That's right, isn't it? Build Robotics and Create Science, which is an initiative of IIT Kanpur, spreading this robotics knowledge. The reason why we handpicked a few of you here for this is that we hope some of you will continue with this field. We have sent a proposal to Army Headquarters recommending that from now on, every MTech course, we detail officers to do work in the field of robotics as applicable to the core of signals, cognition, artificial intelligence, communications, and that kind of stuff. So you'll probably find yourselves, some of you, those of you who get interest and meet the grade, would find yourselves working in these fields and subsequently forming what we hope would be the core team that inducts robots into the Indian Army. So you may well consider yourselves to be pioneers. You're certainly pioneers as far as knowledge in the subject of the Army goes. I can state with authority that once this workshop is over, you'll probably be the most knowledgeable as far as robotics is concerned, anywhere in the Indian Army. The MCME is doing something, but nowhere else, core of signals, you guys are going to be the authority on robotics. Some of you will be here for a little longer. Maybe we'll have another series of workshop in maybe in collaboration with BRICS. See if we can step up the level a little bit for those of you who are interested. We'll work out those modalities as we go along. The team that we've got, as I mentioned, is an extremely competent team. I don't have to comment on the competence of the team. Some of you will sleep. Afternoon sessions are drowsy sessions in summer despite the air conditioning. Try and stay awake. It will be worthwhile. And while the knowledge should rub off, I do hope most of the passion will also rub off on most of you. Because I would like to see a large number of you who are participating in this extending your knowledge further and assisting the Indian Army in inducting robots. So I will, with that, I will hand you over to Rajiv Sinha and his team of professionals. Thank you.
Okay, good afternoon friends. My name is Rajiv Shankar Sinha. Before starting, I would like to introduce myself as well as the BRICS. I am IITK graduate in 2008 from Department of Physics, MSc Integrated. You will find that my work and my subject at IIT Kanpur had no relation. Actually, this was my hobby to work on these type of things. Slowly it became my profession and currently I am working in the field of robotics. The BRICS. The BRICS group was started in IIT Kanpur in 2002 with the help of few faculty members and my seniors. When I also got admission in IIT Kanpur in 2003, I also joined this group. I worked with this group for last 8 years, and currently I am the coordinator of this group. Right now this group is handled by a company called Simplifix Automation and Solutions Private Limited. From now, means right now, it's not a part of IIT Kanpur. Now it's a company. So during in this BRICS, we conduct workshops and training programs, especially for engineering students all across the country. Especially in summers, we conduct 1 month training program for all engineers. So in the series, we are here to conduct a 7 days workshop on embedded system and its application. Okay, so without wasting much time, I would like to start embedded system. So what is embedded system? Before coming, you might have heard that you are going to attend a workshop on embedded system. So you must have a picture in your mind that embedded system is this, that, or something. So can someone tell me what is embedded system? Okay, so actually in simple one sentence, if someone will ask me to answer what is embedded system, explain the embedded system in one sentence, what I will say is embedded system is a simple combination of software and hardware. Okay, software you must have heard, hardware you also know. Okay, whenever we combined these two things, we got a new system called embedded system. So let's see what is this software and what is this hardware. Let's start with hardware. Hardware, it's a simple electronics. Whatever electronics you have seen, you might have seen microcontrollers, chips, resistors, capacitors, all these electronics component combines combinedly called hardware. Okay, now software. Again, whenever we heard this word software, there is something called C or programming which comes in our mind. Okay, so this programming is called software for my embedded system. But there is a small problem. We write program in some language like Java, C, MATLAB or any other language. But my hardware don't know these languages. Okay, so we need a special type of language called machine language which can be accepted by my hardware. Okay, so we need some device which can convert my C language into a machine language. Okay, sometimes we use the word binary file or hex file for this machine language file. Okay, so do you know the name of instrument which is used to convert this C into machine language? Compiler. Okay, so we use a simple compiler to convert my C programming into machine language file. Okay, next. Now I have a machine language file which is a software for my embedded system. I have my hardware. Okay, but the file, the hex file or machine language file, is inside my computer. I had written my code in computer. I have compiled it. After compilation, we have received a machine language file inside my computer. So we need to transfer this machine language file from computer to my hardware. Then only it will work. Okay. So what we will do? We will connect my computer to my hardware using a wire. Wire is not visible on this PPT, but there is a wire between computer and microcontroller. Through this wire, I will transfer this hex file or machine language file from computer to microcontroller. Okay, next. I have connected my microcontroller to computer. I have this hex file. Next, I need a small software to which will help me transferring this hex file from computer to microcontroller. Using that software, I will transfer the file, and this complete system is now embedded system. Okay, I had a hardware, I had written a code, compiled it, connected my hardware to computer, transferred the code from computer to my hardware. Now this is my embedded system. Okay, like this device. This is your embedded system device. To design this device, the company had designed this hardware, then they had connected this device to computer, they transferred a code from that computer to this device, and this is a complete embedded system. Okay, so let's see the things, whatever we have seen in detail. Hardware. The hardware which is used, hardware which we use for embedded system is not a normal, simple electronics. There is something special in my hardware. Okay. That something is called microcontroller. There is a device called microcontroller. There is a special device called microcontroller which is used for embedded system. Okay. Now, if you will go to any shop and will say, "Bhaiya, mujhe ek microcontroller de do." Everyone know Hindi? Okay. So, if you will say, "Bhaiya, mujhe ek microcontroller de do," he will not be able to give you anything. Okay. So, you must know which microcontroller, which family, which company. Okay. So, let's see what is this microcontroller. Microcontroller is manufactured by a different company called Atmel, Microchip, Zilog, Philips. The list is very long. I have written only four names. Okay. So, let's see how many different type of microcontrollers are there in market. There is something called architecture. I am not going to explain what is architecture. This is just a word for us. There is something called architecture, which is a technology behind microcontroller. Based on different architecture, these companies manufacture different type of microcontroller. These architectures are called AVR, 8051, ARM, PIC. Again, we have a list. Okay, these are famous architecture. AVR, 8051, ARM, PIC. 8051 is most popular and oldest one. PIC and ARM, these are later versions, and this AVR is a latest architecture for microcontroller. Clear? Now, the architecture which we are going to use for our practical purpose is AVR. Okay, so the microcontrollers which we will use for our practical during our practicals is based on AVR architecture. Okay, currently AVR microcontrollers are manufactured by only Atmel company. Okay, now let's see what is this AVR. Inside this, based on this AVR architecture, there are different type of microcontrollers manufactured by Atmel. These different types are called family, like Atmega family, ATPV family, Xmega family, ASSP family, AVR USB. Again, the list of families is long. After this session, after the complete workshops, you will be able to work on any family. It's not if you will select Xmega, it doesn't mean ki we will teach you how to work only on Xmega. After this complete workshop, you will be able to work on any one of these things or any of these things. Okay. But for practical purpose, we are going to use a microcontroller from this family, 80Mega. Okay. Now, again, in Atmega family, we have few microcontrollers called Atmega 8, Atmega 16, Atmega 32, Atmega 64, Atmega 128. These are final names of microcontrollers. So, if we will go to any shop and will say, "Bhaiya, mujhe ek Atmega 8 de do," if he will have the chip, he will give you a chip. Okay, if you will say, "Bhaiya, hame Atmega 64 de do," he will give you a chip. Okay, so these are final name of microcontrollers. Clear? During the practical purpose, during the practical session, we will use the microcontroller called Atmega 16. Okay? So, now you know what is Atmega 16. Atmega 16 is a microcontroller manufactured by Atmel company based on AVR architecture. Clear? So, this is my final hardware. Next, coming to software part. to write a program, to write any program, the first thing you need is computer. Okay? The next, if you have a computer, if you have a computer and I will tell you, start writing a code, what you will do? You need a editor. Okay? So you need a editor to start writing a code. Okay? So you, for this AVR thing, you can use any editor. आपकी जो मर्जी है वो एडिटर खोली एंड यू कैन स्टार्ट टाइपिंग योर कोड. बट किसी का चॉइस होता है, आई शुड यूज दिस एडिटर, आई शुड यूज दिस एडिटर. किसी को इसमें अच्छा लगता है, किसी को उसमें अच्छा लगता है. वी एट ब्रिक्स यूज अ स्पेशल टाइप ऑफ नोटपैड और एडिटर प्रोवाइडेड बाय अ सॉफ्टवेयर कॉल्ड इक्लिप्स. ओके, आफ्टर यूजिंग इट यू विल ऑल्सो फाइंड इट्स अ वेरी वेरी यूजर फ्रेंडली नोटपैड where you can write your code very easily. Typing तो करनी ही पड़ेगी, but other facilities जो होती हैं, they are very very user friendly. So you will use a special type of notepad provided by Eclipse. Okay, so using Eclipse, what we will do? We will type our code. Okay, coding बाद में देखेंगे. So we have written complete code. After typing the code, you need to convert this C file into a machine language file. Okay, so for the purpose we need a compiler. Again, there are different compilers available like AVR GCC, CBAVR. These two are famous compilers for AVR microcontrollers. These two are famous compilers for AVR microcontroller. Like C के लिए आपने कौन सा compiler use किया था? Turbo C. Okay. So here we have a compiler called AVR GCC and CVAVR. This AVR GCC is a open source, freely available, so we use AVR GCC. Okay, so we will use AVR GCC to compile my C file or convert my C file into machine language file, or we will use a word called hex file from now. Hex file means a machine language file. Next, I have my hex file inside my computer. Now the final task is to transfer this file from computer to microcontroller. For the purpose we need two things. First, a connection between these two devices. Okay, again there are different type of connections available. The options are serial programmer, STK200, STK500, USB ASP, USB TINI. These are different names of a wire which will connect my computer to microcontroller. Clear? Now to connect my computer to microcontroller, you need some ports on your computer. What are the ports available on computers? Most famous USB, serial port, which is also called COM port, parallel port, LPT. Okay? So these three are most famous ports which you can use to connect your microcontroller to computer. Okay? This serial port. 9 pin serial port, COM port, सब कुछ इसी को कहते हैं. This port can be used for this serial programmer, STK 500 programmer. These two programmers or the interface can be connected to this port. 25 pin parallel port. STK 200 works with 25 pin parallel ports. But there is a problem. आज सबके हाथ में एक लैपटॉप होता है जिसमें ना ही सीरियल पोर्ट होते हैं ना ही पैरेलल पोर्ट होते हैं. We have left with USB port. So we should have something which can provide a facility to connect microcontroller through USB port. So we have USB ASP, USB TINI. Again, there is a long list, but these two are famous connections between USB and microcontrollers. Clear? During the practical purpose, we will use USB TINI. Okay, this is the wire. This is the wire which connects USB port to my microcontroller. Okay, this side we have pins which we can connect to microcontroller. Okay, so this is the wire called USB TINI which we will use to connect my computer to microcontroller. Next, coming to microcontroller part. If you have a microcontroller chip, you will find so many pins like 40 pins, 60 pins, 100 pins. There are different type of microcontroller with different number of pins on it. out of those pins you will always find four pins named MOSI, MISO, SCK, RESET. These four pin needs to be connected to USB Tele, USB SP, STK 500, STK 200. आप कोई भी प्रोग्रामर सेलेक्ट करें, आपको इन्हीं चारों पिन से कनेक्ट करने होंगे. क्लियर? सो हमारा कनेक्शन का कॉन्फ़िगरेशन कंप्लीट है. वी हैव यूएसबी पोर्ट, वी हैव अ कनेक्टर एंड वी हैव पिन्स ऑन माइक्रो कंट्रोलर. यूजिंग दीज थिंग्स नाउ वी कैन कनेक्ट माई कंप्यूटर टू माइक्रो कंट्रोलर. ओके, कनेक्शन इज ओवर. गुड. नेक्स्ट, आफ्टर कनेक्शन यू नीड अ सॉफ्टवेयर which will help you transferring the file. You must have a software जिसपे छोटे buttons हो, जिनको आप click करें तो file यहाँ से वहाँ जाएगी, वो automatically तो जाएगी नहीं. Okay, so we need a software which will help you transferring the file, the hex file from computer to microcontroller. Again, there are different software like PonyProg, AVRDude, SynapProg. AVRDude is open source software which we are going to use for our purpose. Okay, so using AVRDude we will transfer this hex file from computer to microcontroller. Clear? Final? सब कुछ हो गया, हमने transfer कर लिया. And finally we have a device. जो भी device आपने, जिस भी device के लिए आपने electronics बनाई है, जिस भी device के लिए आपने code लिखा है, that device will be on your hand. अब इसको आपको computer से connect करने की जरूरत नहीं है, just give a power supply from any power source and it will work. ठीक है? So this is called embedded system. So this was a summary which we have learned till now. The hardware which we are going to use is Atmega 16, the notepad, Eclipse, compiler, AVR-GCC, computer port, USB, microcontroller pins, MOSI, MISO, SCK, RESET, other than that VCC ground, to sabko pata hi hoga, ye to chahiye hi chahiye. Connections, USB SP, we are going to use USB Tini. Downloader, AVRDude. To have these softwares, कौन कौन से softwares हमें चाहिए? Eclipse चाहिए, AVRGCC चाहिए and USB, नहीं, AVRDude चाहिए. To have these softwares, we need these packages. There is a software called WinAVR. आप Google पे search करेंगे, first link आएगा download का. If you will click on that, you can download WinAVR directly from internet. It's a free open source software. When you will install this WinAVR, it will install, when you will install WinAVR, it will install AVRDude and AVRGCC. जो दो आपके compiler और downloader थे, ये दोनों install हो जाएंगे. This is a package which have so many softwares. और भी कुछ है, पर हमारे काम की दो ही चीजें हैं, AVRDude and AVRGCC. Next, we need Eclipse. Eclipse is a package जिसको आप direct कहीं से download कर सकते हैं, you can use it. उसको इंस्टॉल करने की जरूरत नहीं पड़ती है. बट टू रन दिस इक्लिप्स यू नीड अ जावा रन टाइम एनवायरनमेंट. टू रन एनी जावा बेस्ड सॉफ्टवेयर ऑन योर कंप्यूटर यू मस्ट हैव जावा रन टाइम एनवायरनमेंट. इट्स अ बेसिक थिंग. ओके, सो आपको WinAVR, जावा रन टाइम एनवायरनमेंट एंड इक्लिप्स, ये तीन चीजें इंस्टॉल करनी पड़ेगी टू स्टार्ट. ओके, गुड. SynapProg इज ऑप्शनल, आप चाहें तो इंस्टॉल कर सकते हैं, नहीं चाहें तो कोई जरूरत नहीं है. गुड. एनी क्वेश्चन, कुछ ना समझ में आया हो, एनी कंफ्यूजन फॉर दिस मच थिंग? क्लियर है सब कुछ? गुड. सो लेट्स सी द हार्डवेयर वंस अगेन. हमने तीन बार हार्डवेयर को देखा, पहली बार सिर्फ हार्डवेयर वर्ड सुना था, दूसरी बार थोड़ा डिटेल जाना, तीसरी बार और डिटेल जाना. लेट्स सी द हार्डवेयर वंस अगेन. दिस इज माई Atmega 16, 40 पिन चिप. ब्लैक कलर की चिप हमेशा देखी होगी, छोटी बड़ी हर साइज की आती है. दिस इज अ 40 पिन चिप, 40 कॉल Atmega 16. एज यूजुअल पिन नंबर 1 स्टार्ट्स फ्रॉम हियर. सभी को पता होगा पिन नंबर 1 यहीं से स्टार्ट होता है. ऑन एनी चिप यू विल फाइंड अ कट, ऑन द दिस साइड ऑफ द कट यू विल हैव पिन नंबर 1. ओके, और पिन नंबर फर्स्ट और फर्स्ट पिन. ऑन दिस साइड ऑफ द कट, on this side of the cut you will have pin number last. Like this is a 40 pin chip, so 40th pin is here and it goes like this, 1 2 3 4 5, 20, 21st, 2nd, 3rd and 40th pin. Clear? So this chip is called Atmega 16. Now on this chip pin number 33 to 40, these pins have a special name called port A. इनको हम port A कहते हैं. Clear? Pin number 40 is called zeroth pin, first, second, third, fourth, fifth, sixth, seventh. Clear? In short, we can say this is A1, A0, A1, A2, A3, A4, A5, A6, A7. Means if I will say pin number A7, means this pin. Clear? Similarly, port B, pin number 1 to 8. 1 is 0th and 8 is 7th pin. Port C, pin number 22nd to 29. 0th pin start from 22nd, 7th pin goes to 29 number. Okay? So port A, B, C, and here we have port D. It start from pin number 14th and goes to 21st. Clear? So A, B, C, D. Other than these 32 pins, other than these 32 pins, we have 8 more pins. 5 here and 3 here. Clear? Out of these 8 pins, pin number 9 is called reset. Pin number 10 and 30th pin are called VCC. Everyone know what is VCC? It's a power supply positive terminal. Pin number 11 and 31st, ground pins. It's a power supply negative pin. Pin number 32nd, this is a reference pin. जिसके बारे में हम बाद में जानेंगे क्या होता है, अभी सिर्फ नाम देख रहे हैं. These two pins are useless for us. Okay, ये कुछ special काम के लिए use होता है. For us, it's a useless pins. So, we know the name of all 40 pins for Atmega 16. Good. Now let's see inside the microcontroller. हमारे microcontroller के अंदर क्या होता है? This is a complete picture of microcontroller. You can see B0, B1, B2, B3, B4, B5, B6, B7, and on the other hand there are one more name, MOSI, MISO, SCK, RESET. इन्हीं चारों का मैंने नाम लिया था. यही चार वो pins हैं जिनको आपको USB टीनी से connect करने होंगे to transfer the hex file from computer to this device. Clear? Next, inside our microcontroller. Yes. हाँ, crystal. Actually, in this session, we are not going to teach anything about crystals. Okay, so that's why I told that it's a useless thing. Useless means useless for this session only. Okay. Actually, those XX pins are used for crystals. Oscillators, to connect an oscillator to microcontroller. But in this microcontroller, there is an inbuilt clock. So, no need of to connect any external thing. Okay. Now, what is there inside our microcontroller? Kisi microcontroller ke andar kya hota hai? Registers. Do you know what is a register? Can anyone define a register? Koi bhi. ओके आपके हाथ में कुछ है वो दूसरे हाथ में जिस पे आप लिख रहे हैं उसको उठा ऊपर कीजिए इसको क्या कहते हैं आपका डेफिनेशन फेल हो गया रजिस्टर इज अ प्लेस वेयर वी स्टोर इंफॉर्मेशन एनी प्लेस वेयर वी कैन स्टोर इंफॉर्मेशन इज कॉल्ड रजिस्टर क्लियर वो डिजिटल हो एनालॉग हो कागज का हो पत्थर का हो पत्ते का हो डजंट मैटर If you can store information on that thing, it's called register. Clear? Inside our microcontroller, also, we will see so many different definitions of new words or now old words. Okay, during the session, I will show you so many new definitions. So, registers. Register is a place where we can store information. Inside our microcontroller, we have registers. Inside our microcontroller, we have registers of size 8 bit. The 8 bit register means a location where we can write a number starting from 0 to 255. Okay? That place is called 8 bit register. 8-bit register is a place where you can write a number starting from 0 to 255. It's a digital register, so you can write only numbers. ABCD नहीं लिख सकते, सिर्फ numbers लिख सकते हैं. Okay, so inside our microcontroller we have so many registers, ढेर सारे होते हैं, भरे हुए होते हैं. Okay, let's see those registers one by one. Now, we have port A, port B, port C, port D. To control any single port, we have three registers. We have three registers inside our microcontroller. Okay, let's see what are the roles of those registers. To control port B, we have three registers, जिनके नाम है PORTB, DDRB, PIMB. Similar for A, B, C, D. बाकी सबके लिए सेम होंगे. For A, you will have port A, DDRA and PIN A. Here we have port B, DDRB, PIN B. There are two words, port A and port, or I should say port B and port B. जब भी मैं port B बोलता हूँ, it may be this name or it may be that port B. ओके, इट्स लाइक जो लास्ट टाइम हमारे पास पोर्ट बी था वो इंग्लिश का वर्ड पोर्ट और बी था. यहाँ पोर्ट बी इज अ नेम. लाइक किसी का नाम अगर प्रकाश है, सो देयर आर टू टाइप ऑफ प्रकाश. प्रकाश मैं उनको संबोधन करने के लिए भी बोल सकता हूँ और प्रकाश मैं लाइट के लिए भी यूज कर सकता हूँ. ओके, सो हियर ऑल्सो दिस पोर्ट बी वर्ड इज अ नेम, इज जिसका नाम है, एंड पोर्ट बी इज अ इंग्लिश थिंग. ओके, सो वी हैव थ्री रजिस्टर्स, पोर्ट बी, डीडीआरबी, पिन बी, टू कंट्रोल पोर्ट बी. Okay, now at any time you can change the value of these registers. Like right now it's a port B equal to 0, you can change it to port B equal to 12, port B equal to 33, DDRB equal to 69, DDRB equal to 255. You know how to change the value of registers. Whenever you define a variable called INTI, somebody define kiya hoga? That I is actually a register in your computer. जब भी आप I की value change करते हैं, उस register पे जो value लिखा होता है, वो change हो जाता है. Similarly, we have predefined registers inside our microcontroller, जिनके पहले से नाम fix हैं, आप उनके value similarly change कर सकते हैं, जैसे I की change करते हैं. I equal to आप कुछ भी लिखते हैं, और वो change हो जाता है. Here also you can change the value like that. Now, there is a restriction. You can't change the value of pin B. You can't change the value of pin B register. Clear? Next. आपको जब microcontroller के बाहर छोटे छोटे pins दिखाई दे रहे थे, सबको feel आ रहा है क्या दिख रहा था? Those wires, जो wires बाहर microcontroller के बाहर दिख रहे थे, those wires are directly connected to this pin B register. Those wires, those external wires are directly connected to register pin B. It means B0, pin number 1 of microcontroller, B0 tha, that B0 is connected to this bit. Similarly, B1, B2, B3, B4, B5, B6, B7. All those 8 wires are directly connected to these register. It means if the value of this bit is 0, the potential of B0 wire will be 0. If the value of this bit is 1, the potential of that wire will be 5 volt. Clear? You can't ask a question ki sir yahan 0 aur wahan 5 volt hoga to kya hoga? It's impossible. Aap ek wire ka potential ek hi time define kar sakte hain. When you are saying its value is 0, actually it's 0 volt. वो जीरो नहीं, जीरो वोल्ट है. When you are saying its value is 1, it's a 5 volt. तो आप एक ही सेंटेंस को दो तरह से नहीं कर सकते हैं कि आज दिन भी है और रात भी है तो क्या होगा. ऐसा इंपॉसिबल है. ओके, सो आइदर इसकी वैल्यू 1 होगी या 0 होगी. इफ यू आर सेइंग इसका पोटेंशियल 5 वोल्ट है, इट मींस इट्स 1. ओके, सो आप इस रजिस्टर का मतलब समझ गए. ये रजिस्टर डायरेक्टली उन वायर से कनेक्टेड है. उन वायर्स का पोटेंशियल अगर जो भी है उससे आप कैलकुलेट कर सकते हैं कि इस रजिस्टर की वैल्यू क्या होगी. Now, if you will connect a small LED सबको पता होगा, to any wire, let's say B0 पे हमने कनेक्ट कर दिया. If you want कि वो LED blink करे, what you need to do is, इसकी वैल्यू थोड़ी देर के लिए 1 हो जाए, थोड़ी देर के लिए 0 हो जाए, थोड़ी देर के लिए 1 हो जाए, थोड़ी देर के लिए 0 होगा. क्या होगा? LED blink करती रहेगी. बट अभी थोड़ी देर पहले मैंने बताया, we don't have permission to change the value of this register. पहले कितना अच्छा था, हम लिख देते पिन बी इक्वल टू वन डिले वन सेकेंड, पिन बी इक्वल टू जीरो डिले वन सेकेंड, और उसको इनफाइनाइट लूप में डाल देते प्रोग्रामिंग करते समय. क्या होता, थोड़ी देर वन रहता थोड़ी देर जीरो रहता, थोड़ी देर वन रहता थोड़ी देर जीरो रहता, और हमारा काम हो जाता. बट देयर इज अ रिस्ट्रिक्शन ऑन दिस रजिस्टर. इस रजिस्टर पे एक रिस्ट्रिक्शन लगा हुआ है कि आप उसकी वैल्यू चेंज नहीं कर सकते हैं डायरेक्टली. इट मींस कि आप इस दीवार के उधर खड़े हैं और आपको इधर आने की परमिशन नहीं है. क्या आपके पास परमिशन है उधर से इधर आने की? नहीं. बट देयर इज अ वे, आप उधर से जाइए घूम के रास्ते से आ सकते हैं. हियर ऑल्सो वी डोंट हैव डायरेक्ट परमिशन टू चेंज दिस रजिस्टर, बट देयर इज अ वे. लेट्स सी द वे. These two registers will help me changing the value of this register. Okay, let's see how. Whenever you will write one on any bit of this register, DDRB, it will connect this bit and this bit. बात समझ आई? आप जैसे ही उसको वन लिखेंगे, ऊपर के और नीचे के बिट कनेक्ट हो जाएंगे. Like this. हमने लिखा DDRB equal to 9. It means यहां 1 आ जाएगा और यहां 1 आ जाएगा. Everyone know binary system. Whenever you will write DDRB equal to 9, ये bit और ये bit connect हो चुके हैं. ये bit और ये bit connect हो चुके हैं. Now I know how to change these bits. We can change these bits. When I will change this bit, this bit will also get changed. Like this. You must not have any confusion in these three registers. Bit. हाँ, क्योंकि ये दोनों कनेक्टेड है. बट हेयर यू कैन सी दिस इज वन, दिस इज नॉट वन. व्हाई? दिस इज नॉट कनेक्टेड. हेयर इट्स कनेक्टेड बट हेयर इट्स जीरो, सो हेयर इट्स आल्सो जीरो. देयर आर फोर कंडीशंस, यू कैन सी ऑल फोर कंडीशंस हेयर. हाँ, इट्स अ लिटिल कंफ्यूजिंग थिंग. इन दिस कंडीशंस एक्चुअली आई डोंट नो द वैल्यू ऑफ दिस बिट. डू यू नो द पोटेंशियल ऑफ दिस पीस ऑफ मेटल? लेट्स अज्यूम दिस इज अ मेटल. वी कांट डिफाइन द पोटेंशियल ऑफ दिस मेटल. व्हाई? इट्स अ फ्री बॉडी. आप किसी से जब तक इसका रेफरेंस नहीं सेट करेंगे, यू कांट डिफाइन द पोटेंशियल ऑफ दिस बॉडी. राइट नाउ दिस इज अ फ्री बॉडी. आई डोंट नो द पोटेंशियल, दैट्स व्हाई आई हैव रिटन जीरो. ओके, सो व्हेनेवर यू विल राइट जीरो 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 हियर, दीज बिट्स विल बी फ्री. सो आई कांट आंसर कि उसकी वैल्यू वन होगी या जीरो होगी. क्लियर? इन टेक्निकल लैंग्वेज, मैं टेक्निकल लैंग्वेज में समझाने की कोशिश करता हूं. हैव यू हर्ड अबाउट द वर्ड इंपेडेंस? डू नो द मीनिंग? फ्री बॉडी का इंपेडेंस कितना होता है? इनफाइनाइट. इट मींस इसका पोटेंशियल कुछ भी हो सकता है. किसी भी बॉडी का इंपेडेंस जीरो नहीं हो सकता एग्जैक्टली. बट इफ द इंपेडेंस इज लो And if you are trying to change the potential of that body, there will be a high current or there will be a short circuit. Like, मेरे पास ये है, मैं इसको अगर 200 volt से connect कर दूं, nothing will happen. इसका potential 200 हो जाएगा, 500,000 जितना भी चाहूं connect कर दूं. But let's assume कि आपके पास एक वहां plug में एक wire आया हुआ है जिसका potential 250 volt है. AC है, vary कर रहा है, पर let's assume इसका 250 है. If you will connect a 250, exactly 250 volt to that wire. Let's assume it's a DC. Nothing will happen. But if you will connect a 300 volt, there will be a short circuit. Why? Uska impedance low hai. Let's assume kisi ne main switch off kar diya. Now if you will connect 500 volt, nothing will happen. Kyun? Ki uska impedance high ho gaya. Here, this is main switch. अगर आप उसका मेन स्विच ऑफ कर देते हैं तो इनके इंपीडेंस कुछ भी हो सकते हैं. ओके, मतलब इसका इंपीडेंस इनफाइनाइट हो गया. आई कांट डिफाइन द पोटेंशियल. दिस इज मेन पावर सप्लाई जो ग्रिड से आ रहा है. ओके, सो इफ यू वांट वन, इफ यू वांट कि आपकी एलईडी जले, स्विच मस्ट बी ऑन एंड देयर मस्ट बी अ पावर सप्लाई. पावर सप्लाई है, स्विच ऑफ है तो बल्ब नहीं जलेगा. इफ यू हैव अ स्विच इन ऑन कंडीशन एंड देयर इज नो पावर सप्लाई, again it will not be low. Okay, so there are different ways to understand these three resistors, but I think the concept is very clear. Okay, aap jis bhi tarah se samajhne ki koshish kare samajh sakte hain. There are many ways, but the concept is very simple. Okay, good. So this was the first theory for embedded system. Let's see the applications. Ab hum iska application dekhenge, hum kya kya kar sakte hain. Like connect a LED like this. आप इसको 10 करेंगे, the LED will blink. Now you can see कि मैं सिर्फ इसकी वैल्यू चेंज करूंगा और ये LED blink करती रहेगी. ओके, ये पिन V की वैल्यू ऑटोमेटिकली चेंज होगी, नो नीड टू चेंज इट. ये ऑटोमेटिकली चेंज होगी जब आप इसकी वैल्यू चेंज करेंगे. ओके, सिमिलरली यू कैन कनेक्ट मेनी LEDs और 8 LEDs ऑन अ पोर्ट. सबको 1-1 कर दीजिए, सारे कनेक्ट हो जाएंगे. Now whatever value you will write on port B will be visible on LEDs. जो भी आप वहां लिखेंगे LEDs पे दिखाई देगा. Clear? Like this. Okay? Now precautions. There is one more way to change the value of pin B resistor. Externally also we can change the value of pin B like this. Take a wire connected to this pin, connected to 0 volt. The potential of this bit will be exactly 0. Ye sab bhi 0 dikh rahe hain, par I don't know 0 hai ya nahi hai, but this will be 0. If we connect it to 5 volt, the potential of this bit will be 5 volt, it will be 1. Okay, the value of pin B resistor will be 128. Clear? So there is one more way to change the potential of वैल्यू ऑफ दिस रजिस्टर्स. नेवर डू दिस. मैंने क्या किया, 1 लिखा, यहां अंदर से कनेक्ट कर डाला, यहां 0 लिखा हुआ है, इधर से मैंने 5 वोल्ट दे दिया. देयर विल बी अ स्मॉल शॉर्ट सर्किट, आपको दिखाई कुछ भी नहीं देगा. समथिंग विल बर्न इनसाइड योर माइक्रो कंट्रोलर एंड आफ्टर दैट वो पिन काम नहीं करेगा. ओके, यू विल नॉट सी एनीथिंग कि कुछ हुआ, कुछ जला, कुछ फूका, बट वो पिन उस समय से काम करना बंद कर देगा. ओके, सो बी केयरफुल. सिमिलर, आप यहां पे 1 और यहां पे 0 ना लिखें जब यहां 1 लिखा हुआ है. क्लियर? गुड. सो दिस वाज, हां, राइट नाउ द वैल्यू ऑफ पिन बी इज 128. मैंने पोर्ट बी और डीडीआरबी की कोई हेल्प ली, बट आई हैव चेंज द वैल्यू. कैसे किया पता है? क्लियर है? हाँ, मैंने वायर लिया, 5 वोल्ट की बैटरी से कनेक्ट कर डाला. ओके, ग्राउंड को ग्राउंड से और इसको 5 वोल्ट से, चेंज हो गया. नेक्स्ट. क्लियर है? ओके, इट मे बी कंडीशन कि मैं बाहर से भी कनेक्ट कर दूं और इट्स इंटरनली कनेक्टेड. इन दैट केस इफ देयर विल बी अ पोटेंशियल डिफरेंस, देयर विल बी अ शॉर्ट सर्किट. ओके, लाइक हियर यू कैन सी, मैंने यहां से 0 वोल्ट सप्लाई दिया, यहां से 5 वोल्ट दिया है. सो देयर इज अ 5 वोल्ट पोटेंशियल डिफरेंस बिटवीन दिस पॉइंट एंड दिस पॉइंट, एंड दिस पॉइंट इज कनेक्टेड टू दिस पॉइंट. नहीं, दोनों कनेक्टेड होंगे. हाँ, that's why that is a problem. लाइक आई हैव अ ऑब्जेक्ट, मैं इसको 10 वोल्ट से कनेक्ट कर दूं, इसका पोटेंशियल क्या होगा? 10 वोल्ट। अगर मैं इसे 20 वोल्ट से कनेक्ट कर दूं, इसका पोटेंशियल क्या होगा? अगर मैं इसे 5 वोल्ट और 10 वोल्ट दोनों से कनेक्ट कर दूं, इसका पोटेंशियल क्या होगा? दैट इज अ प्रॉब्लम हियर। ओके, आई हैव कनेक्टेड सेम पीस ऑफ वायर विद टू डिफरेंट पोटेंशियल्स, देयर मे बी अ शॉर्ट सर्किट देयर, आई डोंट नो क्या हो सकता है। ओके, हाँ, जस्ट बाय राइटिंग DDRB इक्वल टू 128 इन प्रोग्रामिंग। ओके, दीज टू रजिस्टर्स आर प्रोग्रामेबल। मैंने प्रोवाइड किया, आई हैव प्रोवाइडेड 5 वोल्ट, इट्स गोइंग हियर, यू कैन रीड इट, दिस इज अ रीडेबल रजिस्टर। नो नीड टू डिफाइन, जस्ट राइट 0। डिफाइनिंग मींस चेंजिंग समथिंग, व्हेनेवर यू से आई एम डिफाइनिंग समथिंग, देयर इज नथिंग कॉल्ड डिफाइनिंग मशीन इनसाइड माइक्रोकंट्रोलर व्हाट यू हैव रजिस्टर्स एंड यू कैन चेंज द वैल्यू। ओके, सो आई एम टीचिंग वन स्टेप ahead this defining word. Okay, so defining means changing the value. अगर आप यहाँ 0 लिखते हैं, it means you are defining this pin as input. If अगर आप 1 लिखते हैं, you are defining this pin as output. Okay, so आपके definition के हिसाब से भी सही है, clear? Any more confusion? जिन लोगों ने पहले से microcontroller सीख रखा है, maybe थोड़ी सी confusion हो, क्योंकि languages change होते रहते हैं. Clear? Good. Let's see the application. Okay, till now we have learned how to blink LED using a programming. Just by writing a code, we can blink LEDs. Coding, there is nothing special. आप जैसे C की programming करते हैं, similarly you can do all the programming. So, वही while loop, वही for loop, वही library, वही सब कुछ. Just you need to change two things: compilers, and you have few predefined variables. वेरिएबल्स एंड रजिस्टर्स सेम ही चीज होते हैं. दो जब वेन एवर वी टॉक अबाउट इलेक्ट्रॉनिक्स वी कॉल इट रजिस्टर, वेन वी टॉक अबाउट इन टर्म्स ऑफ प्रोग्रामिंग वी कॉल इट वेरिएबल. ओके, लेट्स सी द अदर एप्लीकेशन ऑफ दिस मच थ्योरी. क्या हो गया? अच्छा, मैंने कुछ दबा दिया. आई वॉन्ट टू ड्राइव अ स्मॉल मोटर, अ मोटर विच रोटेट्स एट 12 वोल्ट, a motor which rotates at 12 volt and consume 200 milliampere of current. I want to drive this or control this motor through programming. Okay, I have a microcontroller. I know how to change the potential of these pins from 0 to 5 volt, and these wires can provide me a current up to 40 milliampere. The problem is this: I have 5 volt 40 milliampere, I need 12 volt 200 milliampere. ऐसी कंडीशन हमेशा आती है. लाइक
मैं कुछ बोलूं तो आपको सुनाई नहीं देगा.
Why? Your requirement is high, my supply is low. So I use a amplifier. Here also we have same problem. So we will use a amplifier. There are different type of amplifiers available. Let's see one. There is a chip called L293D. D लिखा हुआ नहीं, but there is a chip called L293D. Okay, on this chip, you will find a few wires to connect it on ground. Ground के wires होंगे. You will find few wires connected to 5 volt. Need to be connected to 5 volt. ओके जस्ट फॉर पावर सप्लाई 0 वोल्ट देंगे 5 वोल्ट देंगे. देयर विल बी अ पिन विच नीड्स टू बी कनेक्टेड टू हाई वोल्टेज. हाई वोल्टेज मीन्स अ वोल्टेज स्टार्टिंग फ्रॉम 5 वोल्ट टू 50 वोल्ट. हाई वोल्टेज मीन्स लैक वोल्टेज. ओके हाई वोल्ट मीन्स इट्स रेंज इज 5 वोल्ट टू 50 वोल्ट. क्लियर. सो यू कैन कनेक्ट अ हाई वोल्टेज टू दिस पिन. नाउ यू विल हैव 4 इनपुट पिन 4 आउटपुट पिन. द फीचर इज द प्रॉपर्टी इज whenever you will give a supply of 5 volt here, you will get a high voltage here. Clear? Whenever you will give a supply of 5 volt with very minimum, very negligible current, you can get a high voltage with 1 ampere of current. Clear? Chip ka rule. Aap idhar se change karte hain, idhar change hota hai. That's all. Similarly, we have 3 more pins. Clear? Now we can we connect it like this. This is my microcontroller. Uske bahar ke do pin hai. I have connected these two input of this L293D. I have this motor. I have connected here. Yahan 5 volt diya. Yahan 12 volt de diya. Why? Because my motor runs at 12 volt. Agar aapka motor 24 volt pe run karta hai.
Things that you can't do.